just to clear your minds and put your to the Lord and let him have his way.
Father God, we thank you for this day today. Father God, we come before you today and we ask that your anointing and your blessings, favor, grace be on this day, Lord God. We ask that as brings forth the word, Lord God, that you put fresh anointing on it, that it be fresh bread for us, Lord God, and that we take it into our hearts, Lord God, and walk and run with it even, Lord. And Father God, we pray for those that are even on their way here, that you would give them travel mercies, Lord God, that they make it here safely, Lord God, to be able to hear your word, Lord God. And Father God, we come against any spirit that would try to stop this service today or try to come into this place, evil spirit, we stop it now in the name of Jesus and tell it to go back to the abyss where it came from. And we pray your anointing over this service, Lord God, and we give you all the praise, all the thanks, and all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah. much better.
Oh, better.
It's better than life. Said it's better.
Better.
It's better than life. So much better. Yeah.
It's better than life.
Said it's better.
Oh, it's better than life.
So much better.
Oh, it's better than life.
Oh, it's better. Oh,
it's better than life.
Oh, yeah, it's better.
It's better than life.
So It's you I live for every day, Lord.
You I live for every day.
Gives our arms a little bit of exercise, too.
You I live for every day. It's you I live for.
Lord, this is our praise offering this morning.
You I live for.
We're letting you know it's you I live for, Lord. Every day, Lord God. We can't make it a single day.
I live for every day.
Church, did you hear? Did you hear what I asked? I asked you to pray in the Spirit right now. Lift up your voices. Just pray in the Spirit. Things prophetically about what's going to happen, and we heed it. He said something very powerful this morning, that there was a spirit of deliverance that was going to manifest in our service today. Because that's what we're supposed to be known for. That we might see demons manifest. But there would be a deliverance spirit, and God wanted our eyes to be open because he's training us to watch for these things. And then he said also, watch our pastor. When he steps into that gifts and those callings, we hook up. We hook up with him and what he's getting by the Spirit of the living God. Amen?
Amen.
I'm telling you, church, we will have such powerful services. And the words that have been spoken over this church, you want to keep coming in late? Well, I'm going to tell you, there's going to be an hour when you're not going to be able to get in. Amen?
Amen.
They're going to be lined up out the door because they're going to hear of signs, wonders, and miracles taking in this place.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I want to be part of the hub. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo! Hallelujah. Let the glory of the Lord.
Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Oh, let it rise. Oh, 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 let it rise.
Glory to God in the highest. Amen. He's worthy. Thank you, Sister Tina, for waving the banner. Waving the banner of praise. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, what you all need from the Lord this morning? You just need Him. Anyone else? Joy. Amen. Right there in line with you. Anybody else? Peace, wisdom,
fire.
Strength, fire, healing, restoration. You know, restoration can mean a lot of things, like I want my hair restored. I'm probably in line with some guys. Well, you know, that is not too difficult for God. Amen.
Amen.
I want my teeth straightened out. And, you know, there's been services that's happened with people. Teeth have been straightened. Yeah. Fillings have been filled in with gold. I mean, you know, we don't need to limit our God. He's a limitless God.
Amen. Amen.
So, you know, believe when we come for signs, wonders, and miracles that those manifestations happen. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's not sell our God short. He is so great and mighty beyond what we can even ask, think, or imagine.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we're just going to begin to worship. And if you want to come up to the front, that's fine. You know, like I said, sometimes I just find coming up to the front is, you know, not as distracting, you know, in other places. The altar is an anointed place, always has been. Things happen at the altar. God speaks to you at the altars. There's really a heavy presence of God right now in this place. We don't want to offend Him in any way. We want to reverence the presence of God this morning. Because He is a holy God and He is so worthy to be praised, to be adored. And it's of our own free will that we come. It is. God doesn't make us do anything.
I see the cloud. I step in. I wanna see your glory like Moses did. Rose.
Your breath.
worship you, God. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. To our God. Hallelujah to the greatness of who He is.
Hallelujah.
He is our God. We are His people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
The splendor of the King.
Of the King.
Let all the earth rejoice. All the earth rejoice. He wraps Himself in light, and darkness tries to hide and trembles at His voice. Trembles at His voice.
He stands,
and time is in His hand.
Oh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Savior more than
thank you,
Savior.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful
Hallelujah.
Savior.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Have your way, God. Have your way, God.
Wonderful Savior.
Wonderful Savior.
Thank you, Lord,
Hallelujah.
Mighty God.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Mighty God.
Wonderful Savior, wonderful Savior. Wonderful Savior.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wonderful Savior.
Oh,
my God, my God. None like you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
None like you, Lord. None like you.
How great
Hallelujah.
For the day is coming, saith God, when the splendor of the Lord will be revealed. And yea, saith God, the hills will flow with honey and with new wine, saith God. For yea, just as your pastor spoke and said that there was a breakthrough and that there was a refreshing of the spirit of the living God, so yea, it is true and amen, saith God. For yea, saith the Lord, I am breathing a fresh breath upon this congregation, upon this church, throughout the world, saith God. For my church, I'm breathing on the dead bones, just like Ezekiel dead. And yea, saith God, you are rising up into a new place in me, into new levels, saith God, with the power and the authority of the Holy Ghost. So yea, saith God, be ready to see what the Lord is doing in your midst. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How great is our God. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You can be seated. Thank you. How's everybody doing today? Wasn't it nice yesterday?
Say that again.
Nicer today and nicer tomorrow.
They keep on going.
Brother Adam, how you doing, man? Brother. How you doing, sister?
I'm blessed.
Highly favored?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to ask you one time to do this. If you want to come up here, you can come up here. If not, don't bother. Right here's the seat.
Hurry up.
Now, everyone in the room, please stand and lift your hands in silence. I don't hear any noise, nothing.
in silence. Everyone in the room, thank you, mighty God. Except me, I get to talk. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for your anointing, your presence, Lord, Father God, and thank you for this freshness that I feel. It's over the whole building, Lord God. It's in the heavenlies. I feel it raining down. Thank you for your power, Lord, Father God, and you bringing us into one mind and one accord, Father God. I feel the anointing right over there. I feel the anointing right over here, powerful anointing. My knees are getting weak. It's so strong. Thank you, Jesus, mighty God. Thank you, Father. You're a jealous God, and you want all of us. The depths of our soul. You want our hearts, our mind, our ability. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. You can be seated. So what did you do yesterday in the weather? You washed your car, you say? Barbecue. What'd you barbecue? Steak and ribs. Shrimp. Barbecued shrimp? Is that good?
Yes, it is.
Huh? It is good? You rode your bicycle. How many miles?
I try to do 10 to 30 miles a day.
10 to 30 miles a day. Galatians chapter 6, verses 1 and 3. Or just read verses 1, 2, and 3.
Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault...
Turn that mic up here on the monitors, will you?
Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted.
Verse 2.
Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
And verse 3.
For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself.
Back to verse 1. If a man is overtaken in a fault, look at your neighbor and say, if a man is overtaken in his fault, we, you and I, which are spiritual, shall do what to the man? Restore. Say restore. See, that's what the body is, a place of restoration. A place where you can be restored if you're weak, if you have fallen. This is the place to be restored.
Amen.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
So if a man's caught up in a trespass, he who is spiritual shall restore him. In the spirit of gentleness. Look into yourselves. That you not be tempted, or if you were tempted, you can be restored. Say restored.
Restored.
Say restored.
Restored.
Say this is a restoring place.
Restored.
Say it again. This is a restoring place.
Restored.
Pulled up a couple scriptures here. I'm not going to read these, but I pulled up a couple places here where I read about John and Mark and Peter. And you know, Peter, he failed Christ to me, it was a time of torment and hatred and horrible things were going on. Peter denied him. Say, denied him.
Denied.
And the Bible says this, if we walk in maturity, we can be restorers. Say maturity.
Maturity.
Say, I want to be a restorer
of
the breach. I want to restore those that have been fallen to the wayside. It's kind of strange about God and His grace. If you've never had God's grace, or have never had to accept God's grace, Grace is a tough thing to swallow. It is. It's a hard thing to swallow because it isn't just for us. It's not just for me. It's for everyone in the room. I think of someone that's done the most foul things, and the grace of God can take care of it. But I myself, I don't have that ability. I don't have that inside me. There are certain people that does things to kids that I would.
Amen.
Or to women. Yeah, or old folks, right? Yeah, absolutely, brother. In my ability, I'd like to take them out back and beat them and then repent. That's right. And I'm sure my wife has it in her too. Boy, I tell you, when we first got married, she was a scrapper. And but I tell you something about her mother. Her mother, they were raised in the Methodist church. Her mother gave her a good right and wrong. This is right and this is wrong. There's no shades of gray. It's either right or it's wrong, and that's the way she's raised up. And may I speak and say this just for a minute? You've learned grace, haven't you? You've learned what God's grace is, haven't you? I've learned it over the years, God's grace. It boggles my mind every time someone can go out and do the horriblest things and come right back into God's house, lift their hands up and say hallelujah, and he just accepts them right in. Restores them back to their first place and just touches them and just moves on them. And matter of fact, he might even call them up to have them do something. Who knows what goes on? But I know God's grace is it's something that's so hard to understand. I guess that's why he says it's unmerited, because no matter what we do, we'll never reach the ability to say, God, we deserve your grace. We don't deserve nothing. Nothing. By grace we've been saved. It's not of ourselves. It's the gift of God.
Amen.
So back to Peter for a minute. Peter denies Christ in the moment of the greatest need. He denies Jesus Christ. And I'm thinking to myself as I'm putting this message together the other day, and God keeps saying to me, the backslider's coming back to my house. You better receive them.
Amen.
He said, the backslider's coming back to my house. You better receive them.
Yes.
There was a church here in the Waterford area, I think it was, and the minister, we got a lot of stuff from their church. It was over when we were on Oakland Avenue. We got a lot of stuff from their church. And their minister was a Church of God minister. And this guy had fallen so many times with women. He had fallen and fallen and fallen and got back up. And everybody kept restoring him and restoring him. And the last time he did it, he moved and took off into Alabama. And I don't know what's happened to him, but I think there's a point where you're going to have to give an accountability.
Amen.
Even with God's grace, I know grace covers a multitude of sin, but there's somewhere you have to give account. You have to be accountable. And I think to myself, God, you are so forgiving. You are so forgiving. But even with David, he forgave him, but he paid a price for it. Somebody give God praise for a minute. Somebody give God praise for a minute. So sometimes when we fall and I personally think I'm not doing enough. I can just pound myself and I'm not doing enough. And then the Lord says, my grace is sufficient for you. You need me in your greatest need, no matter how bad you beat yourself. And most people do that. I'm not doing enough. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. And you could be doing all you could do. And he says, stand and know that I'm God.
Amen.
Stand and know that I'm God. And that's a hard thing to do. To walk in the grace of God. And there's nothing we can do to get in a better fix with him. So I say to myself, and this is me, I say to myself, do I got to travel this road again? God, it seems like I learned that lesson. Do I have to travel this road again? The road of fear, defeat, I'm not doing it right. And then he goes, in your greatest need, there I am. When you need me the most, there I am. He says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I'll be with you forever. Sometimes you feel like you're left on the side of the road for dead. And all the travelers are going past you. Nobody's helping. Nobody's stretching out a hand to say, I know what you're going through. Because sometimes you're in a position where people can't do that to you. So you have to have this wall you hide behind when you're going through emotions. And everyone goes through them. And you experience things that other people don't experience. And you get into this little shelter place and you hide and you think, I'm the only one that's went through this. I'm the only one that's going through this. And if you just reach out, somebody look at you and say, I just went through that. And let me tell you what I had to do to get through it. Yeah. Somebody praise him for a minute. So here's what you have to do. You have to experience the incredible grace of God. And no matter how many times you think you're fallen or you're hurting, God's grace is sufficient for you. Look at your neighbor and say that to him. Say, God's grace is sufficient for you. Say, the backsliders are coming back. We better be ready. So here we go. We say, well, Pastor Mark, I am lacking in total commitment. I'm lacking in total commitment. I cannot see through this. I think probably the ones that are not lacking in total commitment are going to have the toughest time seeing through grace. Because those that are committed to God can look at the one that needs to be spiritually brought back up and help them on their feet. Yes. Through the world, there's millions. There's thousands of hurting brothers and sisters. And I want to say that again. Thousands of brothers and sisters that are in pain and they're hurting everywhere. And God's saying to his house, they're coming back and you're going to have to restore them. You're going to have to restore them. To what? To the hope that's in Christ Jesus. That's our job. Say, that's our job. Look at somebody right now and say, this is my total job is restoration. Get to your feet and praise him for a minute. Praise him for a minute. I said, praise him for a minute. I said, praise him for a minute. I said, put your hands together and praise him just for a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. So I take a look at this and I look at this message and I think, boy, all the people that are hurting and the things that they're hurting from. And the fire is going to get hotter. Somebody say, the fire is going to get hotter.
Fire.
Somebody say it again. The fire is going to get hotter. John 15, 1 through 5. Could you do that in the New American Standard? John 15, 1 through 5.
I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away.
Stop. Hit that top part again. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit. And I have so many people say to me, Pastor Mark, I'm going through this, and it seems like every time I get through this, I'm going through this again, and this again is to make you bear fruit. That's what it's for. It's to make you bear fruit. Go to Galatians 5:22. Not yet. Finish this.
And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes it,
more. Man, I got to walk this road again? To get pruned again? I'm tired of being pruned. Somebody say, I'm tired of being pruned. I think the people that get the most pruned are going to get the biggest reward. Finish it up. Verse 3.
You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you.
4.
Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, so neither can you unless you abide in me.
5.
I am the vine.
I am the vine, Christ. You're the branches.
He who abides in me and I in him, he bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing.
Nothing. I cannot do anything but except stay on my face and say, I have to produce fruit. That's what I have to do. I have to produce fruit. The Bible says, I have been crucified with Christ, and therefore I die. I've been crucified with Him, so therefore I die. And those that die and have been through a death is the ones that's, they're going to receive the person back that has done the most foul thing. John 13, 4, 34 and 35.
A new commandment I give to you.
A what? A new
commandment.
Say new. Yell that out. Say new. Brand new. Why was it new? Because it was Him. He was new. He was the new covenant. So He says that when He says new command I give to you. He's speaking of Himself. New command. I am the new and living way. Go.
That you love one another even as I have loved
you. Now that
you.
Is so hard to do. I'm going to tell you, we've been in the ministry a long time. And when I look at people, it seems like it's a lot of people, they go and then you got to come back and you got to keep filling them. You got to keep filling them. And I guess that's what the love of God does. I wouldn't want God to look at me and go, how many times do I have to fill you up? Would you? I want God to look at us and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Look what you've done. You've accepted the lost and the hurt and the dying, and you've brought them in and lifted them up. And that's our job. Amen. That's our job. If we lose sight of that, we're in trouble. Say, if we lose sight of that, we are in trouble. Finish this.
That you also love one another.
35.
By this all men will know that you are my disciples. Disciples.
All men will know because of your love that you're my disciples. If you have loved one another. Remember when I first started out, I said there's a lot of brothers and sisters that have left the churches. They're gone. They've been hurt. And then, you know what happens when people get hurt? They go out and they try to start something without leadership. And they go out and they try to start these little prayer groups with no leadership. And they're not under any protection. And they try to put something together. And then all of a sudden, because they've been hurt, they start a fresh new occult. And then they begin to walk away from Christ and say, well, if the church is Christ, I don't want anything to do with the church. Look at it. It has never accepted me. And I want to thank everybody in the room. Do you guys remember the guy who used to come in here? He'd come right down there. You remember who I'm talking about? Nobody said one word to him. Nobody looked at him funny. He'd be reeking in alcohol. And he would stand there and worship God. And he'd tell me, he'd say, Pastor Mark, when I get right. Now, who's put that in him? When I get right. I said, brother, you don't have to get right. Just come up here and play the keyboard. He said, I can play every instrument up there. Fluently. He said, I'm the best at the keyboard, though. But he wouldn't even come to the platform. Because someone put inside him, you have to get right before you get to church. Church don't make you right. You got to get right before you get there. What kind of nonsense is that? It's stupidity. So if we could have just maybe ministered to him a little more, he wouldn't have froze to death on a doorstep.
Amen.
I don't know. That's what he did. We got to dig a video out of him. It says, if you're my disciples, you're going to love me. Luke 19:10. My.
For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost.
That's what he came to do. Go. Verse 11.
And while they were listening to these things, he went on to tell a parable. Because he was near Jerusalem, and they supposed...
They never understood what he was saying all the time.
That the kingdom of God was going to appear immediately.
Here he is. He's standing right before them. They still didn't understand it. Matthew 9 says he felt compassion on the people. And that's where we're lacking in the church is compassion.
Amen.
How can you tell you're lacking in compassion? You can have compassion in the church or a seeming like compassion. And when you walk out the doors, it's different. It's different. I learned, just learned that lesson last weekend, didn't we, honey? Again. How many times do you have to go down that road? So he says, you come unto me, all you that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That's what people need when they're on the world. They need rest. They need God. Say, they need God. So here's what we're supposed to do as the church. Here's what we're supposed to do as the church. Luke 4:18-19. This is what we're supposed to be. Luke 4:18-19. We're not supposed to be a dress parlor where we look at each other and see how we dressed. We're not supposed to be that. We're not supposed to be a money-driven body. A lot of ministers make the church a business-type atmosphere. We're supposed to be anointed, walking in the power of God, helping the blind, those that cannot see spiritually. Those that are bound, we're supposed to help them. That's what our job is. Read it.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
This is Jesus speaking, but it's the same Spirit. Say, it's the same Spirit.
The same Spirit.
Say it again, it's the same Spirit.
The same.
Say it again, it's the same Spirit.
The same Spirit.
Okay, go ahead.
Because He has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives.
Release. Have you ever had a release? Anybody ever in here ever had a release on something? Something you were praying over and you're praying and all of a sudden you get this big release. Like you're praying maybe over one of your kids and you're just praying. All of a sudden this big release comes in your life and you feel it. It's powerful, isn't it? Go.
And recovering of the sight to the blind to set free those who are downtrodden.
Those that are what?
Downtrodden.
Verse 19.
To proclaim the favorable year of the Lord.
Or the favorable year of the Lord. Or that you can go free. Go free. Say, go free.
Go free.
Philippians says that he wants us to bring the peace of God to those that have never experienced peace. He said, if my love is poured out in your heart by the Holy Spirit, you'll be able to do this. So here's what it's supposed to be as a place of restoration. Say, restoration.
Restoration.
Number one, to backsliders. Say backsliders.
Backsliders.
Say backsliders. A little louder. Say backsliders.
Backsliders.
Hurting people. And sometimes I'm going to tell you something. I know everyone in this room. Have you ever sat down and had someone get at your ear and that's all they say to you is the same thing every time?
Yes.
It's the same thing that hurts every time?
Yes.
We're supposed to give them a little direction to get them healed, not just sit and listen.
That's right.
You can be a good listener and give them a scripture to help them get out of it.
Amen.
Can't you? Well, sure you can. This is probably my biggest one is to help people that are asleep. Say asleep.
Asleep.
Say asleep.
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 Asleep in God's house. They hear it when they're here, but when they go out, they forget what it was. See, here's what the minister is supposed to be. He's supposed to be a mirror. He holds this mirror in front of you with the Word of God, and you're looking at yourself in this mirror. And then when you walk out the door, you leave the mirror, and you fall back to sleep. Say, fall back to sleep.
Fall back to sleep.
So here's our job. To help people with bitterness. Say, bitterness.
Bitterness.
You know something? Jackie said something to me the other day that I just flipped out over. And I've heard this statement. People have kids and they say, there's no manual with kids. Yeah, there is. Yeah, there is a manual. There's a manual. But you know, you can go overboard with that manual. You can. You can go overboard with it. You have to show mercy. 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 You can't just, this is the way it's going to be. And not give a kid's grace, unmerited favor. You can't do that. You can't do it with the kids in the church, with people in the church. You can't constantly not show mercy to people. You have to show mercy. You have to give them a little grace. No, Pastor Mark, I don't believe that way. Well, I'm going to tell you something. They're going to rebel.
Amen.
Say rebel.
Rebel.
Say it again, rebel.
Rebel.
And then you can go way too far and give someone too much rope. I was given too much rope. Somebody needed to take me underneath their foot and say, no. No one ever said no to me. I didn't know what the word was. It wasn't in my vocabulary. No. So then it makes people bitter, the way they were raised. Somebody say bitter.
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 The way they were raised. I was raised with a father that, man, you had to be in bed at 7 o'clock and you had to read 4 chapters before you went to bed. You had to do your 15 Hail Marys and I'm just rebelling. And the Bible says that parents shouldn't do that to their kids. Make them rebel. Give them some grace. Give them a little mercy. Look at your neighbor and say, mercy.
Mercy.
Say it again.
Mercy.
See, rebellion's a big thing. God hates rebellion. He hates it. He hates people with an evil heart of unbelief. He hates unbelief. And I tell you, Jackie, this one here is horrible. We're supposed to be able to help people with that stupid Jezebel spirit.
Amen.
I hate that spirit. Don't you? I hate that spirit, that Jezebel spirit. You know how the Jezebel spirit came about? Now I'm not talking about in Scripture, but how it comes about in the church. It's when men don't take their position.
Amen.
And they just let the woman take charge. See, that's a trick from Satan. It's a trick from Satan. See, what a woman does with a man is because the way they're made. A woman keeps a man in check with his morals. That's what a woman does. Well, when a woman wanted to become a man, all hell broke loose. I'm not gonna do that. Well, that's the way God made you. To keep a man in check with his morals. Well, now women are losing their morals, and now we got to bring all these people into God's house because they're coming back, and we got to correct what's wrong. All the wounded people. There's so many wounded people. You can see it in their faces. Somebody stand to your feet for a minute. I want you to lift your hands up and close your eyes just for a split second. Just for a second. I want you to say this with me. This is just a question. What is a body? Now, I'm not talking about the body of church. I'm talking about your physical body. What is a body? Is it just a flesh and blood hunk of thing that's running around and it's just a body that has nothing? No, it isn't. It's emotions, it's will, it's intelligence, it's feelings. People have feelings. You can't just say anything you want to say to them. We've gotten so used to just saying whatever we want to say, and the Holy Spirit has the same feelings, the same response. And when you say just anything you want to say to people, then you'll say anything you want to say to God. And God's not made that way. These guys that think they're on the same level with God, they're in big trouble. Nobody's on that level. Nobody is on that level. So today, here's what we're going to break, and we're going to do this. There's about 4 or 5 people in here, and these broke off of them. Lift your hands up. Close your eyes. I don't want you to see who they are. Hands up over your head, everyone in this church. Say, today.
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 Darkness
is going to leave.
Chronic
sickness.
Sickness that happens all the time is leaving my house. You have some people that are in your family have mental problems. God wants to heal that too. And you're having financial problems.
Yes.
See, these are things that God wants to eliminate in His house.
Yes.
He wants to eliminate them in His house. Who the Son sets free is free indeed. Say, free indeed.
Free indeed.
Say, God.
God
is here today to heal emotions, fears. I cannot heal until I am healed. I cannot minister until I accept ministering to. My. Jesus, mighty God. Just for another second, please, with your eyes closed. I'm looking at a few people in here, and I'm telling you, Jackie, I can feel this right down to the bottom of my feet because I had the same problem. This parent problem where you're holding something against them and you can't let it go, it's going to kill you. It's going to kill you. There's about five people in here. This thing is destroying you. Come in here, and it's just got you by the throat. And you're looking inside you right now, and you're saying, how do you break that thing free? Nikki laid on this platform for 1 year straight, and at the end of 1 year, she was delivered. That was a healing. A healing is a process. A miracle happens right now. A miracle happens right now. Right now. Right now. Memories. Memory of your past. I don't know what's going on in your past, but you're going to have to get healed so you can heal the ones that are coming in the door.
Amen.
You're going to have to get healed so you can heal those that are coming in the door. Pastor Mark, this pastor has done something to me. I cannot get over it. I cannot move forward until I get this thing off me. You know, sometimes, Jackie, that's why we can be sick. We're not walking in forgiveness. And until somebody sparks something inside you, you don't even know it's there.
Amen.
You don't even know it's there. Why am I treating people like this? Well, there's something going on. If you're a minister and you're in bond, you're in shackles, you're in chains with feelings, you're tormented with it. You can't go any further. You're a minister. I just cannot forgive the men that have done this to me. That has messed my whole agenda up. You're still in the fire. Some of you are feeling the fire right now. Come up, walk up here to the altar for a minute. I just want to lay my hands on you. Right down here to the front. Everyone in that, walk right down here to the front. And lift your hands up as you come and close your eyes. Come quickly. We have to break this. This has to be broken. If you're a minister, this has to be broken. These chains have to be lifted off you. The anointing is to destroy the yoke. Say, destroy the yoke.
Destroy.
Say it again, destroy the yoke.
Destroy
the yoke. Mighty God. Father, your people are hurting. They are hurting. They're hurting everywhere. And they're not saying nothing about it. They're dying inside. They're in pain. They're in pain. They're in agony. They're hurting. And our job is Luke 4:18-19. To take the anointing and destroy the yoke. To take the anointing and break the burdens. To take the anointing of the living God and set captives free. That's what our job is. And you said, Father God, who the Son sets free is free indeed. But we have to look inside of ourselves sometimes and say, are we willing to let this thing go?
Yes. Yeah.
Am I willing to let it go, or am I just going to hang on to it? No, we're not going to hang on to it. I have a dear aunt that lost a child at 2 years old. The baby was 2 years old, and it has carried her all the way through her life, destroyed her all the way through her life. She never let it go. There's a point where you have to let it go. There's a point where you have to let God pour in the oil and the wine. There's a point where you have to hear the ministering and say, you know something? This is for me. Something's holding me back. I cannot open the door, but God can open it. God can open the door, and when He does, I'm walking straight through it, and I'm laying down my sword and my shield by the riverside, and I'm going to quit fighting this thing, and God is going to liberate me and set me free.
Yes.
And that's our job. That is our job. Lift your hands up if you came up here. I want you to say this with me. Say, according to the book of Acts. chapter 4. There was a prayer there. And I'm going to repeat some of it right now. I want to hear you guys say this with me. Say, Father, let your anointing come inside me right now. Let my ears be open right now. Let my mind be set free. Father God, I want to admit to you. I need to hear you guys speak it out. I need to admit to you that I am in chains, that I am bound. Father God, no matter what the feeling is, no matter what the problem is, no matter how strong the chains are, no matter how dark the room is, no matter how deep the sickness is, you have come to set me free in Jesus' name. Father, I lay down my heart to you right now. I open my heart to you. I am held back. And I'm breaking those chains right now. The anointing of God is coming on me right now to break those chains in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord Father God, every chain, Lord Father God, every place that is inside of us, Lord Father God, heal, Lord Father mighty God, break that darkness, Lord Father God, in Jesus' mighty name, and touch us, Lord Father God. Father God, we need you, mighty God. We need you, Lord Father God. Jack, you walk down here just a minute. Go down there. You take Margaret with you. Touch them. Mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Mighty God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord Father God, for opening up our hearts today, Lord Father God, and examining us, Lord Father God. Because it's every time, it's the same fire, Lord Father God, that we walk through sometimes. It's the same thing, Lord Father, and today you're setting us free, Lord Father God. These things that have held us are broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Are broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Are broken in the name of Jesus Christ. By the blood of the living God, by His strength. Stripes, we have been made whole, Father God, by His blood, His blood, His blood, His blood, His blood, His blood, His blood. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. The blood of Jesus is against you. You guys get up to your feet and get down here quickly. Come down here quick. Everyone, listen to me just for a moment. Everyone in the room, there's probably only one person here, two people I'm going to call this out to. If you have ever, ever cheated on your wife or your husband, I want you down there on that side of the building. Right down there. If you're in fornication, I want you to come right down here. Fornication is the same thing, but you're not married. It's the same thing, but you're not married. Right down there. Don't be shy, do it now. Don't be shy, do it right now. See, people don't understand this. When you're in fornication, you've married more than one person. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No matter what it is, you've married more than one. When you're in a marriage and you do the same thing, you're married to more than one person. And then that joint that you have made or that agreement with that person has to be broken. It has to be stopped in the name of Jesus. And just because you say, well, Father, forgive me, it don't mean the curse of it's gone. It don't mean the ugliness of it is gone. It's still destroying you. It's still driving you. And it has to be stopped. Men that come in and they say, I can't control myself. I can't control myself. Or the same with women. They come in, I can't control myself. That thing has to be broken.
Right.
Bring them up one at a time. Brother, you know the fire of God. You know when you're in the fire. Don't you? Brother, you know right from wrong. But sometimes that has to be mixed with mercy, brother. You know what I'm saying? This guy has to be. And who the Son sets free, brother, is free indeed. Next, come up quick. Why are you up here? Why are you coming up here?
For an argument.
Break it right now. Brother, we can't set anybody free until we're free. Break it free right now in the name of Jesus. Break it free right now in the name of Jesus. Cleanse his hands, mighty God. Cleanse his mind. That spirit that's in the mind that does that is the hardest spirit to get rid of. Jesus said it was like this. That spirit cannot come out without fasting and prayer. Without Father, in the name of Jesus, I break its authority right now. Who the Son sets free is free indeed by the blood of the living God in Jesus' mighty name. The blood is against you. The blood is against you. The blood is against you. Next, come up quickly. Just step right down there and pray, brother. Yes, ma'am.
When I was buried, I wasn't faithful.
Lift your hands up. Have you ever repented over that? Have you ever felt the freedom of it, though? You haven't? Well, God's going to set your mind free. That's something you ponder on. And it changes your course. You can be walking with God and all of a sudden that happens and your whole course changes. Because that's all you think about. Father, in the name of Jesus, mighty God, set her mind free right now. Right now, in the name of Jesus. It's not going to bother you any longer. I said, it's not going to bother you any longer. It's not going to bother you any longer. You're going to feel a freedom come on you, a freedom to pray, a freedom to fast, and break that curse off her whole family in Jesus' mighty name. Glory to God. Next. Glory to God. Woo. My, God is good, isn't he? Say this with me, Lynn. Say, the blood. I said, the blood. I said, the blood of Jesus is against you. It is against you, and by his stripes, I am whole. Body, soul, mind, by his stripes, I am whole. By his stripes, I am whole in Jesus' mighty name. Go in peace, young lady. Come on. Why are you here, hon? Put your hands up, like what? Father, mighty God, in the name of Jesus, Jackie, come up here. Glory to God. I feel anointing on you. Somewhere you've opened a door to a lot. Somewhere a door got open. You understand what I'm saying, dear? Huh? You do? Somewhere a door got open. But I'm going to tell you something. What happened today, I can feel the anointing coming right now. I can feel the anointing coming right now. And he says, I've come to set you free, saith the Lord thy God. I have come to set you free. When's the last time you prayed in the Holy Ghost? I said, when was the last time you prayed in the Holy Spirit? It's been a long time. Well, right now, when I take my hand off you and put it back on you, I want you to start speaking in the Holy Spirit. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
I said, are you ready?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, do it now. I said, do it now. I said, do it right now. I said, do it right now. I said, do it right now. Do it right now. Jackie, get your hand on her. Keep her praying. Yes, ma'am. Lift your hands up. Stand right there. Close your eyes. Was you raised in the church? You were? Okay. Young lady? You in the black. Hey! You, get up here. Come right around here. Face her. Look, you can open your eyes and look at her. She got delivered from the same thing. Put your hand on her and pray over her right now. You know what I'm talking about, right? Pray over her right now. Next. Yes. Lift your hands up. Close your eyes. You know that's not right, right? You do. Step forward. With more than one person. Or just one. More than one. So you're married to all of them. If you can call off three people, you're married to them. Four people, you're married to them. So that means you're cursed. You got a curse operating in your life. I want you to say this with me. Say, Father, I come to your grace right now. I need your mercy right now. Father, I'd ask that you'd forgive me of fornication, and I would ask that the Holy Spirit would cleanse my temple in Jesus' mighty name. I said, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you, and by your stripes we have been made whole in Jesus' mighty name. Put your hand on her and help pray. Yeah. The chance of prayer. With, is it more than one person? It is? Put hands up over your head and close your eyes. Let me explain something to you first before we pray. Every time you lay with a different woman, you're married to them. In God's eyes, you're married. So you know what that means? When he told the woman at the on the mount, he said, go and sin no more. He said, how many husbands do you have? She said, one. He said, no, you have five. He told her, he said, go and sin no more. So that curse is broken. See, there's a heaviness that stays around you. God wants to remove it. God wants to bring back the joy of your salvation. God wants the power of God to flow in your life. And those things that are hindering you and those deep, dark things that you've not released, God wants to release them today. God wants to bring the anointing and release them today in your life. Say this with me. Father, forgive me of my sins. Forgive me of fornication. For by your stripes, I've been made whole in Jesus' mighty name. Zach, come around here and pray with this guy. He's going to pray over you a minute. Anyone else? Anyone else need prayer? Anyone else need prayer? Anybody else need prayer?
Let go of the old things, Father. Let it go. Let it go. Let it
go. Lift your hands up for you.
Like if I see them, you see the commercial where you look more.
Really, it's not funny. It's a serious problem. Now I'm going to hook you with somebody. I'm going to pray over you, but I'm going to hook you up with somebody, okay? Hold on. Father, say this with me. Father, I need my mind cleansed. And that thing that holds me. First, I want to tell you this, brother. You're not going to like what I'm going to say, but I'm going to tell you this anyway. When you're coming up, how old are you? You fight the same demons your parents fought. You know that?
Yeah, I know.
You fight the same exact demons. I fight the same demons my mother fought, my dad fought. Same demons. I fight the same things. But there's a point in your life you got to get victory over them. There's a point in your life where you have to stop that curse or that demonic force so your kids don't get attached to it. In Jesus' mighty name, Father God, in Jesus' mighty name, loose him from it and break him. Break it. Break it. In Jesus' mighty name. Anoint his eyes. Anoint his eyes, Father God. I said anoint his eyes, Father God. Because that's where it comes in at. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Tad. Where'd Tad go? Come here, brother. I want you two to grab hands and pray right there. Put your hands on him. Pray for him. Woo! Jesus. Somebody in this place has a spirit of fear. Now, I mean spirit. I don't mean it's in your makeup. You can get in your makeup, but I'm talking about the spirit of fear. That thing drives you. Get up here. We're going to break it. Walk right up that way. Come up that way and hurry. It could be three people, but I don't think two of them will come up. Yours is because of words, right? Father, in the name of Jesus, that is the enemy. We chase it out right now in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Fear, go in the name of Jesus. Go in the name of Jesus. Go in the name of Jesus. You walk in fear all the time? Fear of what? Just the spirit. Just the spirit of fear in Jesus' name. A lot of people can't take a deliverance all at once. Because if they're not ready for it, that thing can come back seven times stronger than when it left. Sometimes it takes months. Please stand with your hands lifted up in the air, everybody. Hands lifted up in the air, everybody. Just for a minute with your hands lifted up. Whew. I know it. And it's there, and it's just, especially that trust. You had trust for people, and they're just, Father, in the name of Jesus, mighty God, cleanse her, Lord, Father God, from it in the name of Jesus, and loosed her, Father God. Loosed her. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. Every thought, every principality, every spirit, Father God, we break its power, we break its authority in the name of Jesus. Put your hands up.
I just pray. I want to just that I just keep myself clean and that I don't stray from the path I'm doing.
I'm going to tell you something, brother. Number one thing. If the people you're hanging around are not going to church, do not get around them, brother. Get new friends, because they'll drag you right down. Put your hands up, close your eyes. Father, you've called this young man. He has an anointing on him, Lord Father God. He's asked me to teach him to preach, Lord Father God. He's hungry for you, Lord Father God. And we just pray over him, Lord God. Draw a bloodline around him, Lord Father God. Around his mind, Lord Father God. That when the enemy comes, Lord Father, he will recognize it. And he will turn and go the other way, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Strengthen him right now, Lord Father God. Strengthen him, mighty God, that he stays with you, Father God, and his footsteps are ordered by you. In Jesus' mighty name. Whew. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
This failed this year, and I'm really scared. I just need...
Lift your hands up. Sometimes we just need somebody to talk to. Right?
Yeah.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord Father, you know his heart, Lord God. His heart is seeking after you, Lord Father, and his heart loves you. Father, protect him in the name of Jesus, Lord Father God. And he's up here, Lord Father, with the spirit of repentance on him. He's up here with the spirit of repentance on him. Touch him right now, Lord Father God, in Jesus' mighty name. Jesus' mighty name.
Fear.
Fear. Father, I break that power, that spirit of fear. That thing is a rascal. I break that spirit of fear, its power and its authority in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Whew, sister. Man.
Let me tell you what's happening. My sister's Kenyatta son, that was a son that's contained when I showed you.
Yes,
picture.
Yep.
Well, he just, I'm really going crazy to some more. And Pastor, if I'm there in Atlanta and can't come there, I can't be there.
You got to give him scripture. Do you have your scriptures that I gave you? That's all you can do? You got to, huh? Who else is going to tell them? How can they hear without a preacher? They can't hear. He's probably never been showed those. Wait a minute. Whoa. When are you going?
No, I ain't going around right now.
Okay.
I'm going to New York.
Strengthen her, Father God. No matter when she gets around that, strengthen her, Father God, and let them scriptures pop out of her mouth. In Jesus' name. Well, I'm going to tell you something. I just got something when I laid my hand on you. You might not want to say anything to him because the Holy Spirit, I never picked this up on him, so he can be very violent.
Yes, I got it too. I didn't say it.
Violent.
His daddy killed his mom.
Oh, man. It's on him. It's on him. Violent. Hey, can you guys, everybody, let's do a favor. Let's all come right up here and grab hands and worship for a minute. Everybody, just grab hands. Let's just worship for a second. Let's just worship for a second. He's all I need. He's all I need. Jesus is all I need. Who's got the grandson that's in the trouble? Who's got the grandson that's in the trouble? Come on, walk up here if you have a grandson that's in trouble. Come on. There's one more. One more. Who? What?
My Michael, he's been on. He's not listening.
To who?
Mother.
Oh, the mother. Kenny's not listening to the mother?
No, my grandson doesn't listen to mother. Rebellious, that's what it is.
Is what?
He's a rebellious.
Oh, he is?
Very.
Rebels a little bit now and then?
Yeah.
I hate that spirit.
I can't stand it.
I hate that spirit.
Jesus.
Father, loosed him from that spirit right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, loosed him from
Amen.
That spirit right now. Same thing? Well, how old is he?
16. And one is 24.
Protect him, Lord, Father God, because the one that's 16, ooh. Protect him, Lord, Father, mighty God, in Jesus' name. And those that he's running with, Lord, Father God, remove them.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name. And the thing that he's thinking about doing, Father God,
yes.
Move on him, Lord, Father God.
Yes.
Move on him. Send somebody to stop him.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. No, don't meditate on that.
Yes.
Don't meditate on that. Anybody else need prayer? I want everybody just hold hands there for a minute. Here's what I want you to do. Every eye closed. Let that go down. Every eye closed. Here's what we've been praying in the book of Acts. Chapter 4, verse 30. That healing, say healing.
Healing.
Signs.
And wonders.
Come from our midst. Through the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May, let us speak your word boldly.
Let us speak your word
boldly in the name of Jesus. Now when I count to three, I want you to lift your voices up, start praying in the Holy Spirit. One, two, three, go now. Everyone in the room, start praying in the Holy Spirit. Everyone in the room for a minute, pray in the Holy Spirit. English, however you need to pray, pray right now. Second, please lift your voices up. Keep holding hands. Do not let hands go. Keep holding hands. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, 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 pray. Signs and wonders and healings, mighty God. The disciples prayed for it. Signs and healings, mighty God. Signs, healings, and wonders. Boldness, Lord Father, mighty God. Boldness, mighty God. Glory to Jesus. That go to clubs. They still call them clubs? And I don't know which of the three, but when you step into the next club you go to, there's a bullet waiting for you.
Oh my God.
Hello? Would you? There's three of you that go to clubs. Three. One, two, three. And I don't know which of the three it is. But the next time you walk into the club, there's a bullet waiting on you.
Jealousy. Jesus.
I can even tell you the name and make of the pistol. Hold hands here and pray for a minute, guys. Did you hear what I just said? Somebody say this with me. Father,
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 Father, keep us,
keep us
out,
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 out
of those clubs.
We don't want no bullet.
Don't want no bullet. Please, God, please, God.
Do they still have drummers in those clubs or just CDs?
Huh?
That just hit a spirit. The drum part did.
Jesus.
for a minute, guys. Hold hands. Hold hands for a minute. 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 Keep praying for a minute. Keep praying for a minute. What's that karaoke thing? Do they still do that? Huh? I don't know if this karaoke is tied in with the same thing, but whoever you are, you know what I'm talking about now. Keep holding the hands. Woo! Jesus. 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 You saved? She saved, brother? You never asked her if she's saved before? Are you? Well, bring her up here, brother. Let's get her saved. Jackie. Walk her into the sinner's prayer. Walk her into the sinner's prayer. While they're doing that, stand still for a minute. Does anybody in this room know a guy named Malcolm?
Malcolm?
Yeah. That's an odd name. I mean, it's...
No, I know about him, but I don't know where he's at.
Is he about 6'1", 6'2"?
Yes.
He is?
Yeah, crazy, and I'll get him.
Is he around the area? You don't know where he's at, Malcolm?
When I had Malcolm, he was in junior high school.
Oh. Now, this is closer than that. Yeah.
Is that Malcolm? Malcolm? Yeah, that's Ann. 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 Just Ann.
The
Ann that has the Sunday school class. She worked with him. Yeah.
Could somebody grab her? Jesus. Put your arms around him, hug him.
Come on, man. Cheers, Pastor.
Excuse me.
Come on.
Yeah, oh. Oh, Jesus.
today.
You know who Malcolm is?
Yeah, the lady I live with is her son. He lives in Texas.
He does? Lift your hands up. I just want to pray over him. Let the Holy Spirit just move on him right now and have right away in his life. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, we bind that danger right now. We see it and we bind it in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bind it in Jesus' mighty name. We pray the bloodline around him in Jesus' mighty name. For who the Son sets free is free indeed. You're welcome. You're welcome. Wait, you guys, you know something? Have a seat for a minute. We got a young guy here who's going to do a song. Whoop, whoop. Huh? Yeah, and then she can do communion. You coming, brother?
Hello?
Hello?
Is it on?
Sounds like it is. Sounds like it's on.
Yeah.
Now, you, what are you going to do? Preach to us through a rap? You wrote this, right?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Tell us what your name is.
My name's Moses Mike Rodriguez, and this song is called Never Turning Back. There it goes. All right.
You've got it now.
To me, the Bible is soul food. Everything but the important things beyond the news, like Christians dying. They don't be trying, people be lying, but they won't hesitate to talk about Kim like she's the one who died on the cross for all of our sins. That's a shame, man. Hope I feel the same, man. I bet if I go preach to the world, I won't get an amen. I tell the world, I ain't doing that. Look to God, never turning back. I tell the world, I ain't doing that. Look to God, never turning back. That's okay though, that won't stop me from doing it. Proving it, the glory and grace of God, I don't plan on losing it. I thank God for the life I've been given. In in and out of church. I serve for a living. In a pound of some heat, I got God. Something you cannot beat. It's so sweet when you got the new jet on your feet, but it's gonna be sweeter when it's time for you and him to meet. I'm just doing the work he wants me to do. I hope I see you when I enter through the gates. It's gonna be amazing. He died for our sins, that's amazing. I know what I'm doing, it's not the coolest thing, but no matter what you say, I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray day and night. I know everything is gonna be alright. I tell the world, I ain't doing that. Look to God, never turning back. I tell the world, I ain't doing that. Look to God, never turning back.
Communion time.
We have been in the presence of God today. Today. I thank God. I thank God for this body. I thank God for each one of you guys, and I thank God for Pastor Mark, who allows the Spirit to go free in here. Just take me on, Lord Father God, because I'm ready. Praise God. Praise God. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you may come up now and receive communion.
Whoa, stop, everybody. Lift your hands up for a minute. Whoa. Jesus, mighty God. See, all of a sudden the anointing fell in here for healing. Pop, just like that. Just like that. Jesus, mighty God. I am the God that healeth thee. God that healeth thee. I am the God that healeth thee. I am the God that healeth thee. Jesus. Moraba kotodon antakosa natakalaba. Oh, Jackie, get up. I am the God that healeth thee. 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 Oh. God. Receive that healing. You need your body, receive it. He's here right now. My. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. He is the God that healeth us. God. Healeth thee. Oh. 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 Ramakoso tora makatala katala malakotora. Man.
Oh, man. Whoa.
This is a time to share the bread and the wine together. The Holy Ghost gave me a scripture because I was worried about my sister last night. But you see, God brought her to church today, Sister Margaret. It's nothing impossible with God. He also gave her the same scripture. And I hadn't even had a chance to even talk to her. God knows your needs. If you have been in sin, all you got to do is ask for forgiveness and mean it from your heart. If you don't feel right within yourself, don't come up here for this. Don't do it. Because then the scripture says you're taking on death. Don't do it. Seek someone that you can trust to pray for you and to talk with you about God and the power of His might and what He can do. He can do all things. All things. Come now and take communion with us. Glory to God. Glory. Glory to God. Glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Wonderful Savior. Wonderful Savior. Don't take none of this lightly. Please don't. None of it. We have a pastor that is laboring. Labor pains for the saints hurt. If you ever had a baby, it's worse than that. Don't take it for granted. Please don't. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. Ooh, Jesus. Ah! Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. How many of you know what this means, represents? This, the bread represents the body of Christ. This is a thing that he, with his disciples, he took and broke the bread and told them, come, let us eat. And they took it and they ate it. If you take it and eat it unworthily, you take, eat, and drink damnation to yourself. Lots of things that happen is because we won't face the truth. Let's face the truth today. Haven't you been blessed? I know I have, and I'm grateful for it. Also, you know the reason why I'm not praying over this? Because I know Sister Margaret already did it. I know it's already blessed. He took the cup, which represented his blood that he shed for us. Yes, that was a long time ago, but it makes no difference. The blood still carries the fire. Look how far we have come. Why are you here? You got to have something in you to make you believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Let's thank him as we drink now. This week, watch yourself. Stay in constant prayer. I believe that's what the Holy Ghost was given. Let's stay in prayer. Pray for someone that you know that's being deceived, because sin is deceitful and Satan is very deceitful. Pray for them. Show the loving kindness that our Father has showed for us. They might not want it. Shut your mouth. Pray anyway. Okay? God bless.
If you would read this maybe once a day, Acts chapter 4, verse 23 down through 33. Read 23 through 33. Try to read it a couple times in a week and pray. That's a prayer that the apostles prayed. From Acts 23 to 30. Yeah, 30 through 33. But 30, verse 30 says this. Here's what they prayed. This is their prayer. By stretching forth thine holy hand, or thy hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of the holy child Jesus. And when they all prayed, the place where they were was shaken, where they were assembled, and the Holy Spirit filled the place. And they walked out with great boldness. They were with one heart, and great signs followed the apostles. So I want you to pray that prayer with me, okay, guys? There's nothing wrong with us praying it. If they prayed it, we can pray it.
Amen.
Yeah, all done. God bless you guys.